This program was funded by the European Union to support gender and development, the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, and the following funders.
The little girl dug and dug through the dark night. Her fingertips were raw from scratching the hard earth. She thought she was going to faint from exhaustion, and tears filled her eyes.
How much longer, Ma?
Not long.
What's it going to be like?
It will be wonderful.
Passports? All the passports ready?
What about the police?
Peter, listen. It's not like here. There's none of this whites, blacks and coloreds. Everybody just lives together peacefully.
Are you sure?
I promise. Shall we go on with the story? The little girl stopped digging and watch the first rays of sun.
Passports! What is all this? Hey? Exit only. Yeah, well, we don't want you back.
I'm not coming back.
I see. So you've been in some kind of trouble, eh?
I wouldn't be here if I were in trouble.
Just checking.
It's really none of your business.
Everything is my business.
Ma.
Ugh. Yeah, the quicker we get rid of scum like you and your immoral offspring, the better it is for all of us.
Busted.
Ma, why do you always have to get into trouble?
Peter, you have to stand up for yourself. Come on, smile. We're starting a whole new life together.
Thank you, children. Mrs. McBride, or my McBride as we say here, welcome to Mbeleko School. We are honored to have you here. We look forward to a long and fruitful relationship together.
Thank you, Mr. Morisi. And thank you, children. I've come from a place where many terrible things have happened, so it's just wonderful to be here.
have lived all my life in shattered little bits. Here, I want the shattered little bits to come together.
This is how you spell my name, Mrs. McBride. I want you all to write that down in your books. What's the matter? Don't you have pencils? Okay, never mind. Everybody, stand on your benches. Go on, up you get. Now, I'm going to count to three, and on the count of three, I want you all to jump down and say, "Good morning, Mrs. McBride." One, two, three.
To Elizabeth, in fond memory of wonderful times together, DDM. Come in.
Ah, my dear.
Mrs. McBride certainly has a different approach. My wife will call for this. Tipi roga chide.
We tried to make things relevant, so we always brought a bit of fun into the classroom.
Our children come to learn.
Don't you think they learn so much more if they're enjoying themselves?
We're Shona. We think Shona and we teach in a Shona way.
Oh. Well, enjoy your tea then.
Indiana telling us how to teach. Look! Hey, we have one doing it. These city women.
So, how was your first day?
Okay. Well, Ma, they said women don't smoke here.
Did they? I bet you they don't drink beer either. Hey, it's your friend. Go on, just be back by supper.
Thanks, Ma. We're going hunting.
Hunting? What about your uniform?
Ma, this is Africa!
Maskati?
Maskati?
Can you tell me, where do I find water? How far?
2 kilometers.
2 kilometers? Poverty creates strong currents of fear and anxiety. Poor people are not outgoing. They tend to push aside all new intrusions. They live and survive by making as few demands as possible. They can do with a bit of a shake-up. What are they doing?
Hey, stop that! Go and apologize. Go on.
She's mad.
It doesn't make any difference. She's just an old woman.
She's possessed.
Those people, they don't understand anything. You don't want them around.
Go on. Go to school. Just go. 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 In South Africa, where I'm from, one small group of people thinks they're better than all the rest. Do you think that's fair?
No.
No. Everyone has a right to live their own way, in peace, as long as they don't hurt anyone. Agreed?
Yes.
So, why do you tease that old woman who walks around the village?
The headmaster wants to see you at break time.
The way they treat that old woman, it's like another kind of racism.
There's no easy walk to freedom, Mrs. McBride. Anyway.
You know Mandela?
Of course.
We must be kindred spirits. He's a real hero of mine. No one here would be interested.
Don't give up, Mrs. McBride. Of course, we have our own ways of doing things, but it doesn't mean they can't be challenged.
Absolutely.
Till next week, have a good weekend.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Let's play soccer. We'll beat those champions. Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Mr. Maurice.
I was passing, so I thought I'd come and say hello.
That's very kind. You're my first visitor.
Well, aren't you going to offer me a cup of tea?
Of course. Please, come in.
Cigarette?
I heard you smoke.
I can't stick to the rules all the time.
You certainly believe in freedom.
Honesty. I believe in honesty. Do you think people should change just because they want to be accepted?
Oh, by the way, I brought you something.
Mandela? You shouldn't have.
Kindred spirits. Read the inscription.
To my McBride. In fond anticipation of stimulating times together.
Thank you. I'll treasure it. And please, call me Molly.
Ma, the water's finished.
Good afternoon, Peter.
Good afternoon, sir.
Molly, I must be off. Enjoy the book.
And thank you for the talk. Goodbye, Mr. Maurice.
Goodbye, Peter.
Goodbye, sir. Is there any more tea?
I'm afraid not.
What can I have to drink then?
Oh, Mr. Grumpy. Come on, we'll walk to the tap later.
What did he want?
Nothing. He was just visiting. He's interested in my funny South African ideas.
Well, I wish he'd stop. People think it's strange.
Peter, he was just visiting. And it's about time I started making some friends.
I hear you're a visitor.
What are you trying to say?
Just wondered how you find our dear headmaster.
Well, firstly, it's none of your business. And secondly, you don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know what I'm talking about.
Well, if you really want to know, I think Mr. Maurice is the only decent person around here.
Well, of course, if you think we're not good enough for you.
Being ridiculous.
Molly, there's something I'd like to say as a friend. I've been receiving complaints from parents.
Saying what?
That you've been teaching their children to be cheeky.
That's ridiculous.
They want you dismissed. But I know you are very special person. I could intervene so that he doesn't have to go that far.
Let go of me.
I know you'd want to stay.
Leave me? Is this what you mean by friendship? Kindred spirits? You lying hypocrite.
My Dube. Sit down. Your teacher, Mrs. McBride, is unwell. Perhaps on each one. My duo will set you somewhere.
Ma, what happened?
Not now, Peter.
But Ma!
Can't you see I'm busy? Why don't you go and play with your friends? What is it?
The headmaster said you were mad.
What?
What did you do, Ma?
Peter, it's not true. I am not mad. He's lying.
But why did he say it, Ma? Why?
Peter! I know about the triumphant cohesiveness of African people. They are deadly faithful to their own, not to you, the outsider. Suspended without pay. Pending mental health review. No. No!
What?
Nothing.
So what do you want then?
That old woman. They're teasing her again.
What can I do about it? I'm just like her. They think I'm mad. Do you think I'm mad?
No.
Perhaps I am. Mad. Like that old lady.
Ma, stop it!
Don't tell me to stop it! You don't understand.
How can I? You never explain anything.
Okay, Peter. How is this for an explanation? Everybody hates me. I've got no friends. I'm not fit to be a teacher. I've got no money. And soon they're gonna say I'm not fit to be your mother because I am mad.
Ma!
Leave me, just go! I don't want to hurt you anymore.
Peter. Peter. Shit. What happened?
She fell.
She must be sick.
Ambuya munorwara.
Ndine nzara.
She's hungry.
Peter. I'm sorry. Can you take her home while I get some water?
You are good. Ashita. Tenda.
Poverty has a home in Africa, like a quiet second skin. It may be the only place on earth where it is worn with unconscious dignity. People do not look down at your shoes, which are caked with years of mud. They look straight and deeply into your eyes to see if you are friend or foe. That is all that matters.
Mr. Morisi, are you trying to get him back?
I'm trying to get my job back. What do you think of him?
You wouldn't understand.
Try me.
Mr. Morisi uses women. We've all been through it. Miss Chidea, Miss Kamba, Miss Chigondo, and me.
You mean you also? Thank you.
You want your job back? This is now in the hands of the ministry. It's not for me to decide.
Are you sure?
Quite sure.
This is a beautiful open place. But people like you make it so stifling, it stinks. Just to clear the air, I think the pupils might like to know exactly what kind of upright citizen runs their school.
Why don't we discuss this?
Yes, and why don't we call my Dube and Miss Jadea to join the discussion?
What are you trying to say?
You have used your position to take advantage of all the women at the school, and you've thrown me out of my job. If you can't tell the ministry that I should be reinstated, I will write and demand an immediate investigation into your activities.
Mrs. McBride.
Hey, class, open your notebooks and start on this work. Is it okay? Come back.
Once upon a time, there was a little orphan girl who was so miserable, she decided to run away. So one night, she crept out into the forest. But it was winter, and there was no food anywhere. She didn't know how she would survive. She started to dig. She knew that if she dug long enough, she would surely find a piece of gold. Maneru.
Maneru.
Can I help you?
I wanted to tell you it was my relative you helped yesterday. The family discussed the matter, but we had nothing to give in return. Only someone said to pass by every day on our way to the water table. Then we decided to give you a pail of water. It is all we have.
Tell them, those who judge my country, Africa, by gain and greed, tell them how natural, sensible, normal is human kindness. Tell them that the gods walk about a barefoot with no ermine and gold-studded cloaks.